A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 2nd March, on the front page you have, no minority in Bengal will lose citizenship due to Citizenship Amendment Act. So this is what Union Home Minister Amit Shah spoke at a rally, a pro-CAA rally in Kolkata. And provocative slogans were raised by BJP supporters in Kolkata ahead of this public rally. So the provocative statements which are given by BJP supporters, you know, there is slogan such as Goli Maro Salo Ko, means shoot the traitors. So Goli Maro Gaddaro Ko. So such are the statements, you know, slogans being shouted against the anti-CAA protests. Then here you have fears rise as coronavirus COVID-19 cases deaths hit new high. So the number of countries hit by coronavirus outbreak have climbed past 60. 60 countries have been affected so far, and infections and deaths continue to mount around the globe. The streets are emptied of tourists and workers now. Economies are in a downward spiral. So that is the situation in countries across the globe where coronavirus infections have been seen, deaths have been seen. Iran, Iraq, Italy, South Korea, number of infections are rising here too. Then below you have four more bodies pulled out from drains in northeast Delhi. So a week after the riots broke out in Delhi, police has pulled out four more bodies from drains in northeast Delhi. Despite the recovery of the bodies, the death toll that stood at 42 has not been officially revised yet. So these people whose bodies have been pulled out, they have to be identified. The fourth body was pulled out from a drain in Shiv Vihar, it says. So none of them have been identified so far, but there are many missing complaints too. On page 4 you have environmental activists embrace last remnants of Aravali forests. So Aravali forests are seeing here protests by environmentalists. This is the anniversary of disastrous Punjab Land Preservation Act amendments by the Haryana government. So this region has now seen some last remnants of Aravalis remaining. So against the government's plans to have development and skyscrapers built in the region. On page 6 you have Eurasian otter found in Chilika Lake. So this is the Eurasian otter you can see here, which is an endangered species, a globally endangered species. Also another one is a fishing cat. So these are the species which are globally endangered, elusive, and found in very few places, have been found in Chilika Lake in Orisha. On page 8 you have 80% beneficiaries in AP get pension at doorstep. So over 47 lakh beneficiaries in Andhra Pradesh received their pension, which included social welfare and medical benefits, at their doorstep on the first day of the month. And this covers 80% of the targeted section. So this is in contrast to about 10 days taken in February to disburse pensions to the beneficiaries, covering only 35% on the first day of the month. So now here you can see Andhra Pradesh government has launched this new system wherein designated volunteers disburse pensions at doorstep to the beneficiaries. Then on page 9 you have India is host to 457 migratory fauna, shows latest CMS data. So this is conservation of migratory species data, which shows that white birds make up bulk of such species which India hosts. There are 24 species of migratory fish in India, according to scientists. So here you can see the list of migratory species in India as per conservation of migratory species appendices. So before the COP and after COP, it has been shown. COP's Conference of Parties 13, which was held recently in Gujarat. So it's an international organization whose Conference of Parties was held in Gujarat. So here you can see the number of birds, species, number of mammals, number of fishes, reptiles, and such. So India, a list of 451 migratory species found in India was compiled, and here you can see from 415, 6 species were added later. So it added up to 457. So later added species are also mentioned. You can see in Asian elephant, Great Indian bustard, Bengal florican, ocean white tip shark, Urial and smooth hammered shark. So these are migratory species. Means they migrate and they come. Large group of mammals, you know, especially bats, dolphins, they are migratory species which are found in India. Then below you have water crisis looms large in Himalayan region. Study finds. So this is a report which has flagged rising dependence on springs. It is said 8 towns in Himalayan region of Bangladesh, Nepal, India and Pakistan were nearly 20% to 70% deficient in water supply. On the editorial page, the first editorial is a big bad deal. So this is regarding deal between US and Taliban, which was signed in Qatar in Doha. And this deal, it says it went into USA, which went into Afghanistan in October 2001 after the 9/11 terror attack. It had the goal of defeating terrorists and rebuilding and stabilizing Afghanistan. But almost 19 years later, US seeks to exit Afghanistan, but with assurance from Taliban that the insurgents will not allow Afghan soil to be used by transnational terrorist groups such as Al-Qaeda. So America's desperation is understandable. It wants to exit the war, but what has it achieved is questionable. So it has entered, war has entered into a stalemate long ago. And US has failed to turn it around despite US Presidents Barack Obama and Donald Trump having sent additional troops to. Also, it is feared that US withdrawal will weaken the Kabul government and alter the balance of power both on the battlefield and at the negotiating table in favor of a resurgent Taliban. And the next editorial is viral economies. So this is regarding the coronavirus, how it is pushing the world into a recession and India cannot be immune to it. The lead article is a plural legacy more vital than ever. So this is regarding Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India's deep sense of history, culture and context. And it says it acquires more relevance in today's preserving the idea of India today. And this is Vidha Tribunal Independence. So this is regarding the reframed tribunal rules. They are said to be in contempt of several constitution bench decisions of the Supreme Court. So it is in November 2019 that a constitution bench of Supreme Court in Roger Matthew case declared that tribunal, appellate tribunals and other authorities rule of 2017 is unconstitutional for being violative of the principle of independence of judiciary. And contrary to earlier decisions of the Supreme Court in various rulings. So what was the direction given by the court was that the central government should reformulate the rules strictly according to the principles delineated by the court in its earlier decisions. So what were these rules of 2017? You can see these rules as such, so it was this Finance Act of 2017 which made the amendments. 26 central statutes were amended and the power to prescribe eligibility criteria, selection process, removal, salary, tenure and other service conditions pertaining to various members of 19 tribunals was sub-delegated to the rulemaking powers of the central government. So this is violative of judicial independence. Then on the op-ed page you have no country for protesters. So this is a question being raised. It says what we are seeing is a struggle against a regime that seems to have lost its democratic conscience. So the government is not ready to engage with the protesters, is not ready to talk and hear their demands. Then below you have a deal that increases uncertainty. So this is again regarding US Taliban agreement. It says it achieves some objectives but may not bring lasting peace. On page 12, you have long wait ahead for NRC excluded. So 6 months after they had found their names missing from the updated NRC, which was final list was published on 31st August 2019. So these 19 lakh people in Assam who have been excluded from NRC are anxiously awaiting their chance to be back in the list. So of the 3.3 crore applicants, 19 lakh were excluded in this final list. And they have petitioned in the Supreme Court too. So that is also there. You can see these excluded persons, it was said, will have 120 days to file an appeal at any of the existing 100 foreigners tribunals. 200 more are in the pipeline. So foreigners tribunals are being set up, which in turn will have to dispose of the cases within 6 months. And the appellant has an option of approaching higher courts too. So all this process begins once the excluded people receive notice from NRC authorities. But no such process has been initiated. Sending notices to excluded state government of Assam says could wait until the entire list is re-verified to make it error-free. Because BJP is demanding re-verification of the entire process to weed out Bangladesh's primarily Muslims from the those who have already been included. So they're not happy with the results of the NRC. And that's why no notification has been issued to those who have been excluded. So, and there were more than 55,000 Assam government officials who were engaged in this NRC exercise for more than 5 years, and now they have been released. So what further steps should happen in Assam is unclear yet. On page 13, you have experts raise concerns for India over US Taliban agreement. They say that the proposed Afghan-Pakistan dialogue facilitated at Washington must not cut India out of the region's security architecture. So US withdrawal plan, which has been finalized, you can see on March 10, there will be release of prisoners. Then on May 29, there will be removal of UN Security Council sanctions against Taliban fighters. Then US coalition forces will be reduced, you know, with withdrawals from 5 military bases, and US sanctions against Taliban would also be removed. And finally, by 2021, US Taliban agreement would be completed with full withdrawal of US troops in the 5 military bases presently. So this is the entire US withdrawal plan, the US Taliban agreement. But then concerns are raised by experts with respect to India that we should also have a prominent role to play here, as Pakistan is a key factor here, facilitating dialogue between US and Taliban. Then on page 14, you have, with falling allocation, Navy looks at fleet optimization. So Navy is firm on a third aircraft carrier and 6 advanced submarines under Project 75I, but is also looking for more unmanned solutions as well. So allocation, defense allocation has reduced in the present budget too, but optimization is essential for the armed forces. On international page, you have tough talks ahead as Ghani rejects Taliban prisoner swap. So Afghan's weakened government is protesting against the key component of the US Taliban deal, which is exchange clause, where prisoners are being exchanged. So President Ashraf Ghani of Afghanistan is facing a political crisis following claims of fraud in his recent re-election, but he said he would not commit to a clause in US Taliban deal that calls for a massive prisoner exchange. So something the militants have been demanding for years. So this is a clause, part of this foreign forces pullout, but is not acceptable to Afghan government. And after US Taliban deal, Afghan Taliban deal, Afghan government and Taliban deal is also expected. Their talks would initiate. So those will be tough talks, is evident now. And this is Turkey confirms operation against Syrian regime. So Turkey has announced the launch of an offensive against Moscow-backed Syrian regime, because Syrian regime of Bashar al-Assad is supported by Russia. So Turkey has put pressure on Europe by opening its border for migrants to seek passage to Europe via Greece. And tensions have soared between Russia and Turkey after an airstrike blamed on Syria, which killed dozens of Turkish soldiers in Idlib last week. So Turkey has been fighting here. The Kurds, which are a minority in Turkey, and the Kurds fighters, which are a threat, considered a threat to Turkey, is the reason why Syria has been, a Syrian regime has been, the Turkish government has initiated action against Syrian regime there. Then on Mondays on business page, you have this money-wise coverage, which is not important. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashara.com. Thank you.